Let's just say that this shall be very interesting. Okay, you all. So I was scrolling, and all of a sudden, I got recommended a video, and I clicked on it. And the first little part that I watched, I was like, whoa, this is a lot. But nonetheless, started off with the video and it was very intriguing. Okay. And I thought to myself, this would make for a good, dope discussion because we are a relationship-based platform. And so why not debunk or co-sign some things that could be helping the men out as it pertains to what women are actually looking for, what they like, what they don't like, what they care about, what they don't care about, and we ultimately just learn, evolve, and grow. So this is the video here, you guys. All right, it is from a content creator by the name of Melly Monaco. And this video is titled Six Male Weaknesses Women Care About. Now, again, you all, I'm not going to lie. The first little part of this video that I watched, the rest I have not seen. So we are going to be watching this together for the first time, okay, as a family. But yes, the first part, a lot is going on already. So bear with us, okay? Because, you know, we are adults. So I'm hoping that you all can be mature and, you know, you all can retain the information and have an open mind, okay? Okay. So without further ado, let's go ahead and play the video. Shout out to Melly Monaco. Sis, I'm gonna tell you right now, you off the chain, but let's just see what you gotta say, okay? So let's get into it.
Six male insecurities that women actually care about. Number one, the size of your dick. Yes, I know you've seen porn, and if you feel like you have a little less, that's what's on TV, you might feel a little insecure. Women do want to brag about how big the dick was, but in the long run, we prefer medium. So if you are insecure about your dick, cut your bush, it will look bigger. Also lose some weight because if your stomach is on top of it, we can see it. And stay hydrated so you can perform better. If you're a good fuck, nobody is gonna care about how big your dick is. Number two, height. The new standard is 6 feet tall.
Hold on. Melly, you hold on. You are going in. Melly, you going in way too hard, way too early. You too, please have mercy on me. Okay, please have mercy. Oh my God. Melly, that was a lot, sis. See, I didn't watch all of that. I only saw a brief little moment of it to where she was like, women do care about you. That's all I had saw. I promise. I didn't know she was gonna go this far. All right. She's talking about you need to shave the bush. You too, please have mercy on me. Now, I gotta say this, because I like I said, I didn't see all of that. Melly, she's right. Oh, she's right. So far, she's right. What did Melly say? Melly said, look, women prefer a medium, okay? A medium, we would prefer that over a large anaconda any day. Lord have mercy. Melly, you get me in trouble. Okay, let's rewind it. Okay, I gotta try to redeem myself for YouTube because Melly came out swinging. I mean, literally. So I gotta try to redeem myself. Let me try to clean this up. Woo, Lord. Y'all like the video. Can you do that for me? Like the video, share the video, and subscribe. Let me start by saying this, okay? When women are out here talking about, I need me a King Kong, King-a-ling, they're cap, all right? I would even go as far as saying that, you know, anything above a microscopic is fine, all right? So often we hear about women talking about, oh, you know, I only deal with men that are packing this much, and I only deal with the King Kong Kingalings, and, you know, I don't deal with average. Please stop the cap. The average man is hitting on this. Okay. So if that is the case, that means the majority of women out here are at home with that. So let's not do too much. Fellas, do not allow these females to make you feel insecure. If you are packing average weight, that's fine. All right. And when we talk about average weight, we're talking about the tools. Okay. We got to watch out for YouTube. Melly did too much. Lord have mercy. So don't let a female, you know, have you out here second guessing yourself like, oh my God, you know, I have an average one and that's small. And it, no, no. Best believe she was sprung in her last relationship and he was average at best. No Kevin Samuels. Best believe her baby daddy is hitting on that and she got three kids by him. So clearly she has no issue with what you're working with, okay? As quiet as kept, like Melly just said, a lot of women would prefer a nice medium. It's not too large, it's not too small, it's just right. Goldilocks. Amen? Amen. All right, now, Melly goes on to give y'all some tips and tricks, no pun intended, okay, about how to make it look like, you know, it's a lot. Bigger, girthier, I don't know, than what it really is. And she said that you can shave and that should help with the illusion of, you know, you working with a tree trunk, you know, maybe. But yeah, nonetheless, fellas, don't be out here thinking that because you don't have a King Kong, Kingaling, that something is wrong with you. No, absolutely not. From what I've heard, actually, the King Kongs are very uncomfortable. They do a lot of damage, and not in a good way. And, you know, they can just lead to a lot of problems. And so, yeah, she's right when she says that we would actually prefer a medium. Now, again, as long as you are not a microscopic, and even if you are, there are women out there for you, all right? I actually work with a girl, a little fun fact, and y'all like the video, share the video and subscribe. Y'all got to help us out because Melly, she did too much. It was a girl that I worked with back in the day. I used to work at Lowe's, home improvement. Okay. And she said that she actually preferred men that were working with, you know, fingertips. Okay. And she said, because, you know, the way that she's built and set up, like she can't handle anything, you know, that is too much. So there's somebody out there for everybody. And yeah, all I'm going to say is Melly, in this regard, she's right. Medium is, you know, the best. And I'm just being honest, y'all. Like, nobody wants something that's going to rip the insides. Okay. Anyway, let's continue. All right. Shout out to the micros, though.
Number two, height. The new standard is 6 feet tall. If you are shorter, you should wear Chelsea boots, Timberlands. Put the little thing that you can put in your shoes so you're taller. Wear fitted, not baggy, monochromatic clothes. It's going to create a visual illusion that you are taller. Number three, hair loss.
No, hold on. Melly says that if you are a short man, that you should wear Chelsea boots. Let me look up what a Chelsea boot looks like. I don't know. Chelsea boots. Hold on, y'all. I gotta. Don't worry. I'm going to put it on the screen for you all right now. When it comes to wearing these type of shoes, I'm going to be honest with you and say that I personally disagree with this. I don't want my man wearing Chelsea boots. Okay. Unless they look a lot more masculine than what I can see, but I'm going to be honest with you all. It's going to be a no for me. Okay. If you're short, embrace your shortness. My tip would be for you to make sure that you are carrying yourself with confidence, maybe bulk up, you know, maybe just give the illusion of being a very masculine, macho type of man, confident man. And that is going to make you appear larger than life. But me personally, if I see a man in these boots, I'm going to think he's a little bit, you know, I'm going to think his name is Chelsea. All right. So I personally, you know, I wouldn't go that far, but you know, yeah, maybe. Now, what else did Melly say? Let me see. Let's take it back. She said something about wearing some kind of clothes. Now, Timberlands are fine, I guess. Timberlands are fine, but those Chelsea boots that I just seen, I don't know. I would rather you wear some tennis shoes and just carry yourself with the amount of self-esteem and masculinity to where you look larger than everybody in the damn room. That's me personally. But let me see. Let's take it back. And y'all like the video, okay? Like the video, share the video, and subscribe. And also, let me know, do you agree or disagree in the comments? Let us know, okay?
Hey, the new standard is 6 feet tall. If you are shorter, you should wear Chelsea boots, Timberlands. Put the little thing that you can put in your shoes so you're taller. Wear fitted, not baggy, monochromatic clothes. It's going to create a visual illusion that you are taller. Number three.
Okay, so she's saying if you are short as well, you should wear more clothes that are form fitted to your body to make you look taller as well. That could work. But I'm going to tell y'all right now, this is my stipulation. Do not put on skinny jeans. All right. I'm sorry. I don't want my man in skinny jeans. I don't want my man in capris. And I definitely don't want to see you in no damn Chelsea boots. Okay. Do something else. I'm pretty sure they have other high platform shoes that y'all can put on that look a lot more masculine. But yeah. Okay. We're going to let her have that. Let's continue. Y'all like the video.
Hair loss. I know for men, it's one of the biggest confidence killer. You see it. We see it. Stop trying to hide it. Either go get the fucking surgery in Turkey where they do the whole crazy thing or shave your head. Bald is sexy. Number four, money.
Now, this hold is on. But you can- hold on. Hold on. Melly, you already doing too much. Now, I got to agree with Melly on this. Okay, I gotta agree with Melly on this. Fellas, if you're going bald, shave it off. All right, I'm gonna tell y'all right now. I recently went to a concert, okay, at the beginning of this month, and it was some nice performers there, you know, a little nice little R&B, and no shade, but Jaheim was in attendance, and let me tell y'all something. Jaheim took off his hat, okay? And when I say he looked like Cynthia from the Rugrats, I said, boy, if you don't cut that off, just cut it off. Cut it out and cut it off, sir, all right? Please don't. Fellas, if your hairline is giving rainbow, cut it off. If your hairline is way back here and it's giving throw your skirt, cut it off. Okay. If it's giving Homer Simpson, cut it off. If it's giving, you know, clown, was it Homie the Clown? Cut it off. Do not be out here embarrassing yourself like that. Like she said, bald heads can be sexy. Amen. Yes, they can. They can. And I'm gonna tell you right now, anything is gonna be better than you trying to hold on by a thread to that little piece of lock that you got hanging, that little piece of braid, right? Anything's gonna be better than that see-through eye afro that you got going on, sir. Anything's gonna be better than you constantly having to wear a damn baseball cap, burning up. You got a baseball cap on at the funeral. You got a baseball cap on at the church. You got a baseball cap on at the, you know, Met Gala, whatever. Cut the hair off. Embrace your baldness. All right? Nature intended for you to be bald, sir. I'm gonna need you to just stand on business. Stand on baldness. You understand me? All right? Let that Tommy shine through. Let's continue.
Number four, money. Bitches want money, but you can buy bitches with no money. But if you are insecure about your financial situation, fucking change it. Start budgeting. Live below your means. You don't need that $2,000 car note just to show off. And then at the end of the month, you got no money. You're actually in the minus because you live off of credit cards. If you hate your job, make a plan. Find a side hustle for extra cash. Number five, your body. Women care about your...
Now, she's saying that, you know, money is important to women. And if you feel insecure about your financial status, that you should budget better. You should stop trying to show off. You should get a side hustle and, you know, level yourself up. And I'm not going to disagree with that. However, what I would say is this, you all. All right. A man should never be out here trying to level up for the purpose of getting a woman. It should always be about you, right? It should always be about you making sure that you are self-sufficient, making sure that you are comfortable, making sure that you're stable. And the women, they come as a bonus. They are not the objective. I've seen so many men prioritize women. And they're doing every little thing in their life to get a woman. And, you know, when they don't get the desired result, then they resort to feeling bad for themselves or they start slacking off because it's like, oh, well, you know, the women, they don't like me anyway. So why work so hard? The women don't like me anyway. So why get the money? Well, you should do it for you because you deserve the best. Because you need to be secure and stable because you care about yourself. You want to make sure that you have the freedom that you need. You're able to live the life that you want to live. Like, it's always about you. And the moment that you operate outside of yourself, that is when you will plummet. You will have things come crashing down. Because I'm going to tell y'all right now, depending on anything or anybody outside of yourself for your happiness and for your fulfillment, you're going to be disappointed. So always do it for yourself first. Even when it comes to riding around in expensive cars, right? Fancy cars to where maybe you're paying $2,000 a month like Melly is talking about. If you're doing that with the sole purpose and intention of getting women and getting validation from other people, You're hustling backwards, sir. Now, if that car makes you feel good and makes you feel accomplished, then by all means, do what you want to do, right? But my advice would be for you all to make sure that you are always at the center of every decision that you make. You are the one that you are trying to please. Because I'm going to tell y'all right now, if that is not the case, you will be let down so much in life. Never do anything for the acceptance or validation for anybody, especially not no female. Okay. But let's continue. Y'all let me know if you agree or disagree. You know, it may be some guys out there that's like, no, that's cap. You know, I'm definitely going to be working so hard so I can get women. And maybe that's your stance. But, you know, me personally, I think that's a setup for disaster and disappointment. Okay, but let's see what she has to say. And again, like the video.
Cash. Number five, your body. Women care about your body, but they're not requiring a perfect body. So if you don't like your body, you know what to do. Start eating healthy. Stop going to Taco Bell. Go to the gym and start sweating. And number six, your face. Are you happy with how you look? Being handsome in the face starts with a skincare. Do you got good skin? Do I want to kiss you all day long? If I don't, then maybe you should try. And complicated for men. They send you everything you need and nothing.
Okay, Melly. Now she's advertising. Sorry, but I already had my sponsorship deal with them. I declined it. So, you know, you got to pay me for anything else. But she's right. Nonetheless, even though she did her little plug, she's right. Like women, we like men that are attractive. We like men that take care of themselves. We like men that have nice bodies. Not saying that you have to be a supermodel, but I mean, that wouldn't hurt, baby, you know, because it's going to turn us on. It's going to keep us interested and intrigued. It's going to keep us just, you know, not only in love with you, but infatuated. And infatuation is needed in relationships. Okay. Lust is absolutely needed in relationships. Do not sleep on that. I'm going to tell y'all right now, my husband, he is a personal trainer and he owns his own gym. He's a nutrition coach and all of that. And he keeps himself in tip top shape, you know. And I'm telling you right now, it makes your girl want to do very strange things to him, you know, when I see him get out the shower, you know, because he's not nasty and sloppy and floppy. Like, no, it makes you want to get on your knees and pray. Okay. I'm gonna say that it makes you want to get on your knees and bow your head. Okay. So yeah, make sure that you are keeping your body together. She talked about skin and then she did her little, you know, her sponsorship, but nonetheless, yeah, you know, your skin should be up to par as well. Definitely. You don't want to be walking around with a bunch of crunch bars on your face and pimples, because that makes you look like you're not taking care of yourself. You know, you want to be able to present an image to the women that you are a healthy man, you are a wealthy man, a rich man in more ways than one. I'm not just talking about financially. I'm talking about you're rich energetically. You're rich when it comes to your mental. You're rich when it comes to you being an asset wherever you go and whatever you do. Like all the way around, you want to be the man that exudes that type of energy. And you do want to make sure that your physical, you know, resembles that. You know, so I'm going to go ahead and give Melly I'm going to give her an A minus. Okay. I'm going to rate her an A minus on this list. Because first things first, you know, we got to take points off of the Chelsea boots. Yeah, no. And we got to take points off for what else did she say that I didn't agree with? You pretty much, you know, trying to show off for a woman. Like, that's what I got from what she said, as far as, you know, you getting on your grind. Like, yeah, get on your grind and step your game up to go and get these women if you want the women. No, I don't agree with that. But I will say that the majority of what she had to say was spot on. I agree with it. Although she did come off hot and heavy in the beginning, and I hope YouTube can forgive us, okay? But nonetheless, you know, I'm going to go ahead and give her an A minus on her list, because I do think that she gave some very solid advice. But y'all let me know how you feel about this. Do you agree? Do you disagree? We would love to know. But I love y'all. I respect y'all. I thank you all so much for pulling up with me. I look forward to seeing what you have to say in these comments. And yeah, shout out to Melly Monaco. We'll see y'all in the next dope discussion. Peace.